families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. Thank y'all. How's everybody? I appreciate it. Thank y'all. Thank y'all very much. I appreciate that. Well, welcome to Family Feud, South Africa, everybody. I'm your mayor, Steve Harvey. Well, what do we have here? 10 women. This is good, man. I feel really good about being here. We're back in South Africa. Been here for a few weeks. Want to thank everybody for making me feel welcome. My family feel welcome. My staff feel welcome. We've actually made this a home now, so this is it. Let's get it on. Let's have a good time, everybody. So, this is how the game works. Our researchers have been all over the streets of Mzansi. They've been asking some answers to some really simple questions. Now, the answers are all locked in on this game board. Whichever one of these families answers the most questions, acquires the most points, at the end of the game, we'll have a chance to play for the grand jackpot, 75,000 rand. So let's get it on and meet the families, okay? From Kimberley, it's the Ogle family. Playing against from Mokopani.
Yes.
It's the Semenya family. So if you're ready to get the show started, everybody say yeah.
Yeah.
Give me Linda, give me Ora Tamblia. Just come on, girl. We ain't got time for all that. You already know I'm gonna mess these names up. Be standing over there looking surprised. Okay, let me go again. Omaratile.
Yes, good try.
Omaratile.
Omaratile.
Omuratile.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Hello, Linda.
Hi, Steve.
How are you?
I'm well, and yourself?
Welcome to the show, ladies. Ready to have a good time?
Yes.
Let's go. We surveyed 100 people. We got top 8 answers on the board. Oh, this is going to be so good. This question right here is going to be a teaching moment. Uncle Steve is here. Ladies?
Yes.
What is the most important quality a woman looks for when searching for her future husband?
Honesty.
Honesty. Linda.
Beautiful smile.
A beautiful smile. Pass a play. We're gonna play, let's go. Omoretile.
Yes.
So, what do you do for a living?
I'm a student. I'm doing my matric.
A student? You're doing your what?
My matric, grade 12.
Oh, 12th grade?
Yes.
Oh, high school.
Yes.
Thinking about going to college, maybe?
Yes, university, definitely.
University?
Yes.
Definitely?
Definitely.
What are you thinking about becoming?
A doctor or a surgeon.
So, introduce everybody.
I am Omoratile, the baby
of the
group.
Okay, hold on. You can't just do that and go on. Okay, one more time. Do it one more time.
Rebaga Semenya.
Sa Mamasai.
Thekwana tsa matlo a makhibidu.
Yes. Yes. Don't know what she said. Sounds sexy though. All of them got that. Got to do we did. Yes. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, I'm Omoratile, the baby of the group.
Uh-huh.
Next to me we have Basetsana.
Hello.
Next to her we have Hillary. Then we have Mokgadi. And last but not least, Naledi.
All right, so let's go.
I believe in you.
I do.
Stop believing in me. Basset sign. Basset sign. What does your name mean?
Well, Steve and my family were all girls, and I'm the last born, so we're four girls. I have three older sisters, so my name means girls, ladies. Yeah. Literally, girls or ladies.
Okay, so what does your name mean?
He loved me, as in God loved my parents.
Oh, okay, I like that. Okay, that's pretty good. All right, well, let's go. What's the most important quality the woman looks for when she searches for a future husband?
Well, Steve, I love a good laugh, so humor.
Humor. Humor! Hillary!
Wow.
Got it. Come on now, Hillary!
Got it right the first time, Steve.
Got it right the first time. That's because I'm sharp. What do you do?
I'm a radio news reader, Steve.
A radio news reader?
Yes.
So, like, you're a news correspondent on the radio?
I update people on their news daily, sometimes in the morning, sometimes in the afternoon. I mix it up.
So, how many people listen to your show?
I would say roughly about 400 people on average.
Okay, that's good. You're getting there.
Not quite on your level, but maybe in a couple of years.
See, I'm a little older than you, and I've been doing this a long time. So I built up. When I first started, I had 10,000 listeners. And then I had 1 million. And then I had 3 million. And now I have 9 million. Yeah. Hillary, what's the most important quality a woman looks for when searching for her future husband?
No compromising here. No cheating. I want loyalty. Mm.
Loyalty. Loyalty. Mogandi? Close.
So these two letters, the K and the G, make a kh sound.
Mogandi.
Mogadi.
Mogadi. Mogadi. Mogadi. Got that. What do you do?
I'm a law researcher and consultant.
A law researcher and consultant. All right, let's go. What's the most important quality a woman looks for when searching for a future husband?
I'm gonna go with a stable source of income.
Stable source of income, the ability to provide.
Yes.
No romance without the finance.
Thank you.
Exactly.
The lady.
Yes, but also ask me what my name means.
Well, you know, just one thing at a time. So. I didn't know we was on a time limit here. I just said the name right. Okay, good. Now, tell me what it means. Naledi means... Okay, what does it mean?
Steve, my name means star. Naledi means star.
Star. Mm-hmm. My wife's African name is Lesedi.
Oh, wow. Light.
Which is light.
We.
Wow.
My African name is Matusi.
Matusha.
The helper. Wow.
Helper of people.
Yes.
We were given our African names by the president of Botswana.
My God.
Yeah, so that's what it is.
But that's so nice.
Yeah, I like it. I use it all the time.
Tell people where you're Mutusi Harvey.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna change my name.
Yeah, Steve Mutusi.
No, I'm move over here. I'm buying houses over here.
Hey.
Yeah.
Where are you looking? Where are you looking?
No, I mean, I'm gonna get them every...
I'm not gonna come by. I'm gonna know.
Well, I mean, you can come by, but my wife's gonna kill you, so. You can come. All right, so let's go. What is the most important quality a woman looks for when searching for her future husband?
I definitely want someone with a good education.
A good education. See, now right there, see, me and you, it wouldn't be a good match, because, see, I don't have an education.
That's true.
Yeah, I flunked out
but
of school.
But you made it, so...
You don't worry about that?
Yeah, it's levels.
Yeah, but It'll be plenty romance with this here finance, I'll tell you that right now. All right, here we go. What's the most important quality a woman looks for searching for a future husband?
He must be able to look good, a good sense of fit. Like, he must be able to look good.
He must be able to look good.
Dress sense, a good dress sense.
Must be a good dresser.
Yes. Yes.
She want her man to be snazzy.
Yes.
You know, come out the dough, snap, crackle, pop. Yes. You know, put a little milk on him, he turned into Rice Krispies. Yeah, that's what she want. You know, drip. She wants drip.
Yes.
Come on, just swag, just can't stand it. Just look at him and just go, damn. Yes. Must be a nice dresser. All right, we got two strikes now, ladies. We got to be careful. The Ogle family can steal. What's the most important quality a woman looks for when searching for her future husband?
Yeah, must have a good heart, so kindness.
Kindness! You know, ladies, I gotta say, y'all actually doing pretty good here. You're coming up with some good answers. Are any of you married?
Oh, no. Whoa. To myself.
Oh, okay. To yourself?
On my middle finger, yeah.
Oh, okay, okay. She's crazy. All
right. Okay.
Hillary, let's be careful now. We've got two strikes. The Ogle family can steal. Most important quality you look for searching for a husband.
Okay, he must be a good listener. Empathetic.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. A good listener. Empathetic. Wow. Pull that one out. All right, now, we got two strikes. We gotta be careful. The Ogle family can steal. What's the most important quality you look for a future husband?
Hoping that's on the board, I'm gonna go coming from a good family.
Coming from a good family. All right, ladies, here we go. Here's your shot. What is the most important quality the woman looks for when searching for a future husband?
Respect. He has to have respect.
Oh, respect. Well, we got a game, folks. Ogle family got 83. Semenya family not on the board. Don't go away. We come back. We're playing Family Feud, everybody. Yeah. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Ogle family got 83.
Yes.
Semenya family not on the board. Give me Victoria. Give me Basetsana. Ladies, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Steve.
Victoria?
I'm mighty fine, Steve, and you?
Wonderful, wonderful, every day.
Thank
All right, ladies, surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Give me an excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
My car is stuck.
My car is stuck. Victoria?
The pots are burning.
The pots are burning. Hillary?
The kids, the baby's crying, the kids
the are... The baby's crying.
Yes.
Pass the plate.
We're gonna play.
Mohandi.
Perfect. Without the N.
Without the
D-I.
Win.
Mohadi.
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 Perfect. Okay. that's what I said.
So you had said Mohandi or Mohadi?
And now what is it?
Mohadi.
All right, audience, by show of hands, who in here thinks she crazy? Thank you very much. Okay, give me an excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
Somebody's at the door.
Someone's at the door. My lady, Give me an excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
I'd be like, yo, sorry, someone else is calling me.
Yeah, I got another call. We don't have any strikes. Give me an excuse you might give to get off the phone.
The line is breaking. Like, I can't hear you properly.
I can't. Hello? The line is breaking. Hello? I can't hear you. So we're breaking up. We're breaking up. Well, we're back to you again, darling. Give me an excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
To do some chores.
Got something to do. Got some chores. Only one strike. Hillary, give me an excuse you might give to get off of a phone call.
My battery's about to die.
My battery's about to die. Gotta go. So, ladies, you're doing so well at this, I'm going to assume that you make a lot of excuses to get off the phone. Because y'all just rolling through them. Y'all got all the, hello, okay, how are you breaking up? You breaking up? Oh, I'm sorry, my battery going down and damn near dead. Oh, I'm sorry about somebody at the door. I got to go to the door. The kids, what are y'all doing in there? Damn it, sit down. Guess whose turn it is? Go ahead, guess, because I promise you I can't. No matter what I say, I'm gonna get it wrong. Well, Sheila, give me an excuse. If I'm gonna say it right and get it wrong, I might as well just say what I want to say then. Give me an excuse. We only got one strike, gorgeous. Give me the excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
So I might claim that it's bedtime and I just want to go sleep. I'm tired.
Girl, I'm so tired. I'm tired. Time to go to bed. All right, we got two strikes now. We got to be careful, ladies. The Ogle family can steal. Give me an excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
Like, similar to low battery, I'd be like, yo, my airtime is running out. I can't be
on. Your airtime is running out.
Yeah.
My airtime. Ladies, give me an excuse you might give to get off a phone call.
My break is over, Steve.
My break is over. Number seven.
I'm driving.
Number five.
In a meeting.
Well, that was round two, everybody. We got a game now, folks. The Ogle ladies got 83. The Semenya ladies got 75. We got a close game. We got two good families. Don't go away. We come back, the family's gonna be playing for double the points. We're playing Family Feud. Let's go. Family Feud, everybody. The Ogle family got 83. Semenya family got 75. Give me Jesse. Give me Hillary. Ladies, in this round, we've doubled the points, surveyed 100 people, top six answers on the board. Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people. Hillary.
A funeral.
Funeral. Pass or play?
Pass. I mean, play.
Play, okay. Mojati. Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
So quite contrary to what Hillary said, a wedding, tears of joy.
A wedding! Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
You know, I'm also thinking tears of joy, and right now my degree is trapping me. So at a graduation, yeah. I'd cry.
At a graduation? All right, name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
At your child's birthday party.
At a birthday party. Wow, man, y'all play pretty good. All right, ladies. Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
When your wife's given birth.
Wow, that's pretty good. The birth of a child. Hillary, name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
I'm thinking in a movie theater when I'm watching a really sad movie.
Yeah, that's good.
Crying in the movie theater. All right, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. Ogle family can steal. Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
Well, since I'm considered crazy for being married to myself.
Yeah, you are. You are crazy. Everybody in here know you crazy. Let me tell you something, little lady. You can stop announcing it. We already know. I said your name right. You repeated the same name and said I was wrong. We know you crazy. You done married yourself. You don't know your damn name. But your husband could be watching today. This is the thing about TV. Mm. It opens up your pool. All of you are attractive women on both sides. Your husband, they don't give a damn. I've never seen a family more concerned about themselves. They don't even know they're on TV. Girl, what did you say? I don't know. Did you say something? Is he talking? I don't know what he's talking about. He don't mean nothing to me. What did Steve say? Just stop talking about Steve. We need this damn answer. They doing sign language and everything. Just like a house full of your aunts just over there talking. Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
Right, so you were almost preempting my answer because I was going to say, since I'm married to myself, and that's crazy, maybe I need someone to propose to me, and then I'll cry then, maybe.
That's a good one.
Well, let me tell you what's going to happen. When he proposed to you, he going to cry. At the proposal. Ladies, I haven't been over here to meet you yet, but I've noticed the way you play. You're a very intense group of women. You're very involved in your huddle. You're gonna win a huddle contestant of the year, because no one huddles like y'all. We've been talking about y'all for 5 minutes. Y'all ain't even looked up. She said, Jesse said, really? You've been talking about who? All right, ladies. Name an occasion when you might cry in front of other people.
A farewell. You've seen someone else.
At a farewell. Number five.
Award ceremony.
Well, that was round three, everybody. Ogle family got 247. Semenya family got 75. Don't go away, because after the break, we're going to double the points. You're doing well. Don't worry about it. You're playing well, ladies. We'll be back with Family Feud. Family Feud, everybody. The Ogle family, 247. Semenya family got 75. Give me Cheryl. Give me Mogande. Ladies, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
In this round, we've doubled the points, surveyed 100 people. We got the top 6 answers on the board. Name a professional who needs to know your personal details. Cheryl.
Doctor.
Doctor. Very personal. Let's play.
Let's
Come
play.
On, let's yeah. go. All right, yes. I've been waiting on y'all. Get over here on the grown folks side. Yeah. All right, so Linda, what do you do?
I'm a personal caregiver.
Oh, okay, that's good.
Yep, and I take care of my patients at their homes.
Okay, that's good. Well, introduce everybody.
Well, I have the Ogle family.
Ladies,
we are cute, we are pretty, we are gorgeous and intelligent. Hey! Steve Harvey! You chose us! Come on the show! Go Family Feud!
Hey! Hey, I've been waiting to come over here. Been over there with the kids. Yeah. Get over here with these grown folks. I like the song. All right. Now, introduce everybody.
We have my gorgeous sister, Victoria.
Yes.
My beautiful niece, Jessie. Mm-hmm. And other gorgeous sister, Cheryl. Mm-hmm. And have my gorgeous niece, Claudette.
All right. Cheryl, what do you do?
I work in financial management. I'm also a full-time mom, a part-time student, and an all-time favorite aunt and sister.
Oh, all-time favorite aunt favorite. And sister.
I'm their favorite. I'm everyone's favorite.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, she said it on national TV, so that must be true.
Of course.
All right, Claudette, what do you do?
Well, Uncle Steve, I'm a student of life, which means I'm still exploring.
Okay, well, you're gonna need to get a job pretty soon.
Yes.
Because you can't take exploring down to the cash register. So what do you wanna do, though?
My main focus is on modeling.
Oh, you pretty little something now, you see that? All right, let's play. Name a professional who needs to know your personal details.
Well, Uncle Steve, I will go with a teacher.
The teacher. Linda, name a professional who needs to know your personal details.
Funeral parlor.
General Paula. Victoria, how are you?
I'm fine, Stephen. You?
Good. What do you do, darling?
I work at provincial government, Northern Cape. So what I do there is like basically admin, basic admin.
Okay. You're the boss of the family?
No.
You're not the boss?
You know, I think they think I keep myself the boss, but I don't.
Yeah, no. No, yes, you do. Yes, yeah. you do. No, I can tell. I can tell. You know, I'm very good with people, Victoria. You're in charge of the group.
What?
Yes, yes, yes. You're an administrator. You're very authoritative.
Oh, my gosh.
You're assertive.
Bad qualities.
No.
Okay.
Not at all.
Okay.
So I got you figured out, Victoria.
Thank you.
We only got one strike. Let's figure this out. Name a professional who needs to know your personal details.
A dentist.
A dentist. Jesse, how are you?
I'm fine, and you, Uncle Steve?
Good. What do you do?
I'm working at one of the mines in the Northern Cape.
Oh, in one of the mines?
Yes.
In the mine?
I'm a tip attendant.
You're what?
A tipping attendant.
Dumping?
Yes, you can say it like that, yes.
No, well, I want to say it right. What is it?
Tipping. Tipping attendant. Can I spell it out?
Yeah, oh, yeah, spell it.
Okay, it's T-I-B-B-I-N-G. Can you say it now?
Well, see, I can't spell, so.
It means.
Dubbing?
Dubbing. T with a. Like a D for Tommy.
D as in dummy.
T for Tommy.
Oh, I thought you said D as in dummy. I was going ahead. That's too damn far now. I'm a lot of things. I ain't dumb. You know, I might be a little slow. Oh, T.
Yes.
T as in tummy.
Yes.
I.
Double P.
PP.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. I. And NG.
NG.
So tipping.
Tipping.
Yes.
Okay, now I understand. That's beautiful. Now let's go. We got two strikes now. We got to be careful because the other family can steal. Name a professional who needs to know your personal details.
Psychologist.
Psychologist. Wow. I would have never got that. That's a great answer. Cheryl, the favorite. How are you?
I'm good, thanks, and yourself?
All right, we gotta be careful now, Cheryl. Two strikes, the other family can steal. Name a professional who needs to know your personal details.
Your lawyer.
Wow. Your lawyer. Oh. Ladies. Name a professional who needs to know your personal details.
Uncle Steve, you're gonna go with insurer.
Insurance.
Insurance.
You're all right. You're still in good shape. Don't worry about it. Number five.
Receptionist.
Why? Anybody here to see you?
No.
Number three. You don't need to know nothing but how much I got. Two.
HR manager.
It's the last round. Because all of you have adequate points, all of you have everything to play for. Because whoever has the most points at the end of this round has a chance to play fast money and walk out of here with the jackpot, 75,000 rand. The Ogle ladies, 331. Semenya ladies, 75. Let's get it on. Give me Claude. Give me Naledi. Ladies, in this round, the point values are triple. Surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board. Here we go. Name a chicken meal made with flour. Claudie.
Baked chicken.
Baked chicken.
Chicken a la king.
Chicken a la king. Linda.
I would say chicken pie.
Chicken pie. Ladies, we got four answers left. Victoria, name a chicken meal made with flour.
Well, Steve, in South Africa, this is how we do our chicken. Nah, the one piece of that I'm gonna give you now.
I'm ready.
Fried chicken.
That's everywhere in the world, girl. That's everybody fried chicken. You got to put flour on that chicken to fry it. That's the best way to eat chicken. Exactly. Don't go to fried chicken.
Yeah.
Jesse.
Good answer.
Name a chicken meal made with flour. Only one strike. It's okay. It's only one strike. Hey, Cheryl.
Hey, Steve.
We only got one strike, Cheryl. Name a chicken meal made with flour.
I would go with the chicken casserole.
The chicken casserole. We got two strikes. We have to be careful, Claudie. The Semenya family can steal. Name a chicken meal made with flour.
Well, Uncle Steve, I would go with a chicken pizza.
Chicken pizza. That chicken pizza. Linda, we've got two strikes. We have to be careful. Semenya family can steal. Name a chicken meal made with flour.
Chicken nuggets, Steve.
Chicken nuggets. Ladies, you're not gonna believe this. There's two answers on this board. If you give me either one of those answers, and we triple those points, and you walk out here with a lot of money. That's fair. Now, ladies, you become Uncle Steve's favorites.
Thank
I gotta
you.
Tell you that.
Wow.
You're a lovely, lovely bunch of young women. Very bright, I love you. I want you to win this money. So if you would please answer this question so I can triple this money for you, and then I want you to cheer for these ladies over here, cause they gonna be playing for a lot of money too. Here we go. Let's let everybody win a lot of money. Name a chicken meal made with flour.
How about chicken pasta?
How about chicken pasta? This is for a lot of money, chicken pasta. Number five. Number two. Well, ladies, I love you. You played well. We're not gonna let you walk out of here empty-handed. You're taking away 3,750 rand and a year's worth of KFC to the value of 10,000 rand. Well done, ladies, and thanks to the folks at KFC. Good luck, ladies. I enjoyed y'all. Thank you. All right, ladies, I need two of you. I need two of you to come on out here and play Fast Money. We're gonna play for 75,000 rand right after this. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Ogle family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, now, Victoria, here's how Fast Money works. Cheryl is off stage. She can't see or hear any of your answers. I'm going to ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
You can't think of something, you just say pass.
Yes.
We have enough time, we'll get back to it.
Yes.
If you and Cheryl together come up with 200 points, look back there. Tell everybody what you're going to win.
75,000 rand.
Yeah. All right, you ready?
Very ready, Steve.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. At what age would a parent allow their child to start dating?
18.
Something you studied in maths class?
Algebra.
Something you buy by the liter?
Pass.
Something that can be deep?
An ocean.
Something you can light?
A cigarette.
Something you buy by the liter.
I don't understand that question.
The liter.
The liter, water.
All right, Victoria, let's see how we did. All right, here we go. At what age would a parent allow their child to start dating? You said 18. Survey said? Yeah. Something you studied in maths class. You said algebra. Survey said? Yeah. Something you buy by the liter. You said water. Survey said? Something that can be deep. You said the ocean. Survey said? Yeah. Something you can light. You said cigarette. Survey said? go. All right. All right, Cheryl, I got good news for you.
Okay.
Victoria got you halfway there. She got 102 points. It's very good. You need 98 to win the jackpot of 75,000 rand. Now, let me tell you something, Cheryl. It's tough to get 98 points in the second position, so you got to focus, okay?
Okay.
Come on, ladies, I want y'all to win this money now, okay? Now, yeah. This is how it works. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we're gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Victoria's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. The clock will start after I read the first question. At what age would a parent allow their child to start dating?
18.
Try again.
21.
Something you studied in math class.
Algebra.
Try again.
Geometry.
Something you buy by the liter.
A petrol.
Something that can be deep.
A mine.
Something you can light.
A candle.
All right, Cheryl, let's see how we did. We need 98 points for the money. Come on now. At what age would a parent allow their child to start dating? You said 21. Survey said 16 was the number one answer. 16. Okay. We need 81 points. Name something you studied in math class. You said geometry. Survey said algebra was the number one answer. We need 56 points. Something you buy by the liter. You said petrol. Oh, that's gas.
Gas. Okay. Yep.
Survey said milk. Milk was the number one answer. We need 29 points. For 75,000 rand, something that can be deep. You said a mine. Survey said ocean was the number one answer.
Okay.
We need 29 points. Something you can light. You said candle. Survey said candle was the number one answer. Well, congratulations, Ogle family. That's 75,000 rand. You're walking out here with a grand total of 101,000 rand. Wow. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.